Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back for another TOS video. So we are here to power release our second Druid series, Killer Whale Aloha. As all this, I would say I'll be ranking Aloha as the second best card in the series after power release. Right, we'll go through more of his active skill and his improvement after we evolve or power release this particular card. Right, so let's get into the power release stage. Not sure what am I gonna be facing. Okay, so standard 3 battles power release stage. So we have 4 random runes turn into water after receiving damage. Okay, so we have 3 converts, but I'm only concerned about the mob's attack. Hopefully it's not too painful, so I do not take a big chunk of damage in my face. Okay, so we are off for a good start here. Plenty of sky drop, plenty of water runes and heart runes. Okay, so easy to take down one of these mobs here. Okay, so I'm going to be saving a bit of heart runes to heal up after this spin. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, decent amount of water runes and moving on. Right, so Aloha having CD10, right, CD10. Not sure whether we have a decrease in CD after his power release. Right, so hopefully he goes to CD8 because, to be honest, 10 is a bit long. Like, considering nowadays the meta, I suppose, it is the shorter the CD, the better. Right, so Yun Yang is in a very, I would say, awkward position with CD10 because by the time, most of the time, by the time you hit CD10, the battle is over already. Right, unless you are fighting those super long battles. Right, so we have a time down mob here, but I didn't. Oh, okay, we get a time down after. Okay, I see what they did there. So we have 5 color shield here, and we are supposed to use Aloha's active skill here. Okay, I see what they did there. So I have to stall. Hopefully, oh my gosh, okay. Oh! Did I spin all 5 colors? I didn't even know. I was busy aligning the heart runes, trying to recover my HP, but okay, good for me then. So there we have it, Aloha's power release form. Right, he's becoming, at first he was human, became partial whale, and now he's just he's just a whale now. Alright, so Aloha the wave riding killer. So you can see here we have a change of active skill, extend rune movement time to 9 seconds for 1 round. After that, we turn all runestone into fixed number of enchanted runes, right? Water, fire, earth, light, and dark. So, if this card has been out last time, right? Remember Xuan Yuan Dark Extra, right? It wouldn't be so much of a pain in the ass, right? Because that's our very first enchanted quintet enchanted shield. So, this will be a good card, I would say, if you bring this in a Ether team, right, and for joint operation you get a lot of quintet enchanted shield, right, whereby your guild member will just leave it alone. Nobody wants to clear it because it's quintet enchanted shield. We have Aloha now, right, so it's not that bad. So that's which is why I rank Aloha in the second best of the entire series after power release. Right, so with that we are done. Two out of three cards of the entire series that I have. Right, so next up will be Boy Sienna, but that will be on a separate video. Right, so with this, hopefully you guys enjoy this power release stage. A small little insight before you try to attempt the stage to prevent loss of stamina or whatsoever. I almost lose my stamina because I thought I would have died there. 5 color shield. Alright, so with this, gonna end this video here. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys in my next video. Bye bye.